Okay, let's get started. We're in chapter 18. To successfully breathe in, you need four different processes. The first is to bring oxygen from the outside to the lung. And before you take this class, you think that's breathing, but this is just the first step of breathing. The second step is the oxygen need to diffuse from the alveoli into your blood. And a lot of disease can happen around here, like free periodic lung disease or lung edema. Increase the distance, you compromise diffusion. And that's the second step. The third step depends on your cardiovascular system. Your heart, you need to have a good heart. You need to have a lot of blood, be able to transfer the oxygen from your lung into your tissue. And the last step is here, happens around here. The oxygen need to be loaded from your blood to your tissue. If you have a bad perfusion is the blood flow. The big word to say blood flow is called the perfusion. If you have bad perfusion, it turned out the oxygen could not successfully send to your tissue. And eventually the tissue, your cells, don't have enough oxygen produce ATP. And it happens to some diabetes patients, and they don't have good perfusion, and eventually if they accidentally cut themselves, they eventually have to lose the finger, the toe, because of the bad perfusion. And eventually it's your cells that get oxygen produce ATP. That's what makes them happy. So successfully breathing requires these four different processes. Your PO2 level start from the outside is about 160 millimeter mercury. When you go to the lung, it drops to about 100 millimeter mercury. And this oxygen level will be the same as your oxygenated blood oxygen level. So when we talk about the oxygenated blood, the PO2 level is 100 millimeter mercury. You go to the tissue, the same PO2 level, 100 millimeter mercury. After the oxygen delivered to your tissue, the PO2 dropped to about 40. So in your body, if we say the PO2 level is 40 millimeter mercury, we consider it's the oxygenated blood. CO2 starts from your peripheral tissue. So CO2 reach is about 46 millimeter mercury. And when you go to the lung, CO2 will be sent to your lung and breathe out. So PCO2 level is lower, it's about 40 millimeter mercury. So CO2 level high is 46, low is 40. The lung is the area the gas exchange happens. So oxygen diffuse from the high concentration area, that's the lung, to the low concentration area, that's your blood, and CO2 diffuse back. So simple diffusion is the mechanism. And you use the pretty thin layer of cells there in the alveoli. We call them simple squamous epitheliums. In the blood, in the capillary is a one layer, thin, only one layer of cells. So this short distance helps diffusion to happen. And you also have the local control when the blood flow there, and they will sense the PO2. They're mainly sensitive to the PO2 level. And they're also sensitive to the PCO2, so more it will cause the vessel constriction to the alveoli with low oxygen, high CO2, and automatically the blood will go to the blood vessel. More blood will go to the blood vessel, lead to the alveoli with more oxygen. And that's the local control. And some lung disease can happen. In a normal situation, the lung should look like this. You have the normal PO2 level and normal PO2 level in the lung and in the blood. Emphysema is the lung is like a plastic bag, so it loses elastance, usually due to smoking. Smoking can damage those fiber, elastic fiber in the lung. So it's very easy to expand the lung. You have no problem for inhalation. But now it's like a plastic bag. It's difficult to exhale out. So you have difficult to get CO2 out. For exhalation, there's a problem. So the PO2 level can be normal, can be low, but it turned out in your blood, the PO2 level is low. Free periodic lung disease is usually due to not smoking, it's due to the dirty air. like people work in the minefield for their whole life, or some farmers, especially the animal poops, the bird's poop can cause prebiotic lung disease. It makes the lung tissue turn into the scar tissue, and scars are very thick. So it turned out, even though the lung PO2 level is normal or a little bit lower, the PO2 level would be low in the blood, and everything after that would be low because of the thick distance, a compromised diffusion. Lung edema is you have liquid accumulated in the lung, and this liquid will increase the distance between the alveoli and the blood. So even though the PO2 level in the lung is normal, when the oxygen have to go through the long distance for diffusion, PO2 level is low in the blood, and everything after that is low. The last one is called asthma. Asthma is constrict the airway. When we talk about the autonomic nervous system, you have the beta 2 receptor here. For sympathetic, it can cause the bronchial dilation. An asthma attack is those bronchial constrict. When you constrict, its resistance is very high. It's difficult for the oxygen to move in. So it turns out the PO2 level in the lung is low, and everything after that is low. So this picture, you find I keep showing this picture, this is the main concept. Your oxygen level in the outside, that's the first one to decide your oxygen level. So it can affect by the altitude, you go to the high altitude city, and or humidity. Humidity will affect the outside oxygen level. So if this been compromised, everything after that been compromised. If this is normal, the problem can happen in the alveoli. Alveoli are O2, that's this area. It can affect by the lung compliance, airway resistance, like we talk about asthma. The problem happens around here. And even though the alveoli O2 level is normal, the problem can happen around here. So it goes from the lung to the blood and can affect by the diffusion, like the prebiotic lung disease. It happens around here. Eventually, if this is normal, if you don't have enough blood, you have anemia, it can happen around here. Eventually, you still don't have enough oxygen go to your tissue. So for the successful breathing, you need all four processes to be good, and your tissue eventually is your trillion of cells of tissue. They have enough oxygen to produce ATP. That's what makes them happy. So this slide shows you the alveoli gas exchange can be affected by several factors. I still use this picture to explain. It can be affected by the oxygen level reach the alveoli, and it can be affected by the air, that's the outside part, that's this part. Or can be affected by the alveoli ventilation. This depends on your breathing rate. So when you exercise, you increase the breathing rate, you want to bring more oxygen in. And also your airway resistance, like the asthma attack, it happens around here. How the oxygen can easily move in, move out. Lung compliance. If you don't, like the newborn baby, they don't have enough surfactant, it's difficult to extend the lung. It also affects this part. But it can also be affected by this part, the gas diffusion between the alveoli and the blood. That happens around here, between the lung to the blood. So it depends on the surface area, because the mechanism for the gas to move is simple diffusion. Simple diffusion depends on the surface area. Bigger surface area, the better. Also short distance, the better. Diffusion distance. So if you compromise the thickness, fibrotic lung disease, you have the amount of fluid, edema, lung edema, this will compromise this part as well. Eventually, perfusion is the blood flow called perfusion. You need to have enough blood to go to the lung to carry the oxygen. You also need to have enough blood to send the oxygen to your tissue, deliver oxygen. Eventually, it's your cells, your trillion of cells in your body, they have enough oxygen produce ATP. That's what makes them happy. Okay, let's take a short break.